they can release toxins with potentially devastating effects for marine life.
Experts call it a global threat.
We've got an ugly, dangerous problem, and we're not fearing it sufficiently.
Animals big and small are ingesting those, and how that eventually ends up inside our own bodies.
The UN estimates by 2050 there'll be more plastic in the ocean than fish.
So there's a lot of threats out there in the wild.
The ocean, one of our world's greatest mysteries. A mystery that covers 71% of our Earth's surface, yet only 5% has been explored. To give you a better idea of this, we have explored more of our solar system in outer space than we have our own ocean. 228,000 different species are on record, yet around 2 million still remain unidentified. It is one of our greatest hidden treasures that holds many secrets. But unfortunately, our oceans and everything in it are dying before those secrets can be discovered. Plastic pollution is standing as the number one threat to all life on Earth. Not just our oceans, but it is killing us as well. With plastic destroying oceans, land, and polluting our air, it is causing constant disruption to the circle of life. Species are slowly becoming extinct, some of which help the Earth's cycle. However, though things like plastic pollution and global warming have never been as big of a threat till now, it has now become the number one topic globally. People are starting to fight back, making changes, trying to clean and save our planet. I was fortunate enough to work with two amazing organizations who are trying to fight these problems. ORC Ireland, based down in Cork, and the Seal Rescue Center in Wexford. They were able to talk to me about what steps they are doing to help our oceans and marine life, but also how to look at the bigger picture and how this is affecting our planet as a whole, and how we can help by even changing things in our daily lives.
Hi, my name is Emer Keaveney. I'm a marine biologist, ocean educator, and executive director of Ocean Research and Conservation Ireland, a for-impact social enterprise that's based in University College Cork.
My name is Melanie Crosey, and I'm the executive director at Seal Rescue Ireland. I have a background in environmental science and working for wildlife nonprofits internationally.
Here at ORC, our mission is that we are dedicated to monitoring and minimizing disturbance to marine megafauna. That includes cetaceans, whales, dolphins and porpoises, elasmobranchs, sharks, skates and rays, pinnipeds, seals and seabirds.
The mission of Seal Rescue Ireland is to rescue, rehab and release sick, injured and orphaned seals from across Ireland. We're the only seal rescue centre within the Republic of Ireland, so we're covering nationwide. In addition to rehabbing individual animals, we're also educating the public with proactive conservation programs on how to protect the seals and protect the wild populations as well.
We started Ocean Research and Conservation Ireland because Earth is currently facing its sixth mass extinction. We're losing species faster than they can be discovered. For example, we've lost more than 60% of our wild animals in the last 50 years. In addition to that, there's also a climate crisis that we're facing, and the latest IPCC report led to a global strike for climate. Ireland is committed to generating 70% of our electricity from renewables by 2030. But to do that, we need to move away from old methods with oil and gas.
The greatest tragedy that I've seen in my career was the BP oil spill response in 2010. It was a huge oil spill from a oil platform, oil drilling operation in the Gulf Coast of Mexico, and I was stationed in Alabama, where cleanup operations were there to catch the oil as it came in. My job was a natural resource advisor, so I was doing environmental oversight of the cleanup operations to minimize any further damage to endangered species or endangered species habitat. And it was a really good example of large-scale human impact on a variety of different populations. The wildlife populations in the Gulf are still recovering to this day. I worked with a lot of birds and sea turtles and other animals that were negatively impacted by this, and unfortunately these sort of occurrences are happening all over the world.
Biodiversity face a number of human-induced threats, including overfishing, bycatch and entanglement in fishing gear, noise pollution from oil and gas exploration, and also noise pollution from military sonar. It's also been predicted that there's going to be more plastics in the ocean than fish by 2050.
The biggest threats facing seals are the threats that are facing the entire marine environment. So that's climate change, that's plastic pollution, and that's unsustainable fishing. So oftentimes our seals will come in with really bad injuries or they're exhausted due to severe storms. Seals need to haul out on land and rest and breathe oxygen. So when there's storms that come up, a lot of times they'll get swept away and they can get separated from their mothers and they can get severe injuries. Another issue that we see in our seals is a lot of them have ingested plastics. They are opportunistic feeders, which means they'll eat a variety of different food items. So if their environment is being polluted with plastics that mimics fish, oftentimes they'll eat that by accident and they won't realize their mistake until it's too late. And that also brings us to a big threat, which is entanglements and bycatch. We often get seals brought in that have fishing line or netting around their necks. Sometimes they can drown, sometimes they can be restricted of movement so they can't feed. And sometimes these injuries can get really deeply embedded and cause infections. There have been two seals specifically that have passed away that were found to have plastic in their bellies, but there is an estimated between 100 and 650,000 marine mammals every year die from entanglements and bycatch. It's very hard to tell how many hard numbers because a lot of those animals are out in the middle of the sea where we can't see them. This is why seals are so important as a bioindicator species. They're semi-aquatic, which means they spend part of their life in water, and then they also come up on land, so they're giving us very valuable information about the threats to the marine environment that we might not otherwise be exposed to. Another threat is climate change, of course. Sometimes those really big storms coincide with seal pupping season. 2 years ago, there was Hurricane Ophelia, and it's estimated that 80% of their pups that were born prior to that storm were actually killed because of the storm surges. So with the increase in these storms every single year, this is going to have a long-term impact on the populations.
Our group encounters plastic pollution situations almost every day. So we run beach cleans where we see loads of different types of plastic pollution, from cotton earbuds to old kids' toys to shoes. We also encounter wildlife that have either been entangled in plastic pollution. So for example, Kieran Collins is a director of ORC and he's also the skipper and captain of Baltimore Wildlife Tours. And this summer he encountered a grey seal pup, and it was covered in, well, it was wrapped in fishing gear that was abandoned, and he cut it loose and got it free. But we also have encountered seals that haven't been so lucky. So there was a seal also last year in West Cork that had evidence of something being wrapped around its neck, although the thing was actually gone from it. But at that stage, it was too late for him. He was emaciated and he was probably going to die at that stage.
Each seal that comes into our care is a case study, and we like to tie the environmental threat that brought the seal into our care with the issue that the seal's facing. But because there's a frequency of storms that are occurring more and more, then there's more animals that are being exposed to these really harsh conditions. The same can be said for plastic ingestion or entanglement. All of these are hard-hitting issues, and seals make a great ambassador for a healthy ocean because they're charismatic, they're adorable, they're very relatable, but they represent really, really bad issues going on in the environment. And we hope to build an emotional connection between the public and these issues through these seals.
Plastic pollution can be detrimental to marine wildlife. from ingesting plastic debris in plastic bags to the accumulation of toxins in their blubber and in their blood, which can cause immune response deficiencies and also reproductive problems. And we can see that through a number of examples. So for example, at the start of December, we had a sperm whale that was stranded in the Isle of Harris in Scotland, and it was found that there was over 100 kg of plastics in its stomach. And that included plastic bags, plastic bottles, plastic gloves, and plastic packaging.
So this is an eco brick, and the idea is it's a way to capture your soft plastics or non-biodegradable, non-recyclable waste. Because in Ireland currently, soft plastics are not recyclable. So even if you properly dispose of them the best possible way, best case scenario, it ends up in a landfill. Worst case scenario, it ends up in the ocean. So by putting it into an eco brick, you can actually capture that waste, keep it from polluting the environment, and actually make it into a resource. So this eco brick is just that. It's very dense, it's heavy, and it can be used as a building block to build furniture, garden walls, lots of different structures. Now the idea is they're very difficult to make. It takes a very long time to make a proper eco brick. It can have no open spaces inside, and that can take a long time. So at the end of the day, the real goal is to show you that it is really hard to make these and to take control of your plastic waste. So you will actually find that you're buying less one-time use plastic. And that is one of the most important things that we can all be doing, is using less one-time use plastics. Because every piece of plastic that's ever been created is still in existence today. And by the year 2050, it's estimated there'll be more plastic in the ocean than fish. This is a way to turn the tide on that.
So some of the things people can do to reduce their plastic waste includes buying stainless steel flasks and reusable bags. So if you use a stainless steel flask, you actually save on over like 88 plastic bottles a year. And if you use a reusable bag, you save on over 400 plastic bags a year.
If you come across a seal that seems like it's in distress, you can call our 24-hour rescue hotline, and we'll ask for photos, we'll ask for a description, but primarily what you want to do is maintain a safe distance. We recommend at least 100 meters away from the animal so as to not further stress it. And it's important to keep in mind that any deviation from natural behavior is considered disturbance. These are protected animals, so it is actually illegal to harm them, to approach them, or to harass them in any way. And it is very dangerous. They are wild animals, they can bite, they can spread zoonotic disease. And another issue is dogs on a lead. We every year get seals that are brought in that have been attacked by dogs, and they're very vulnerable when they're on land. So it's important to maintain a safe distance and call us, and we will call one of our trained rescue network volunteers to go check it out. And if it's determined that it might not otherwise survive, we'll get it safely lifted and transported to us at our seal rescue center in Corktown to be properly cared for. One of the biggest success stories I've seen at Seal Rescue Ireland is a seal named Falafel. She was a little baby gray seal. She arrived about 2 weeks old, and we found her on the beach in Arklow. Now, she did have some injuries, and she seemed very lethargic and exhausted, but we did notice that she had some markings on her back. And after some investigation, we learned that this seal, at 2 weeks old, had swum 90 miles across the Irish Sea from Wales, where they were doing population surveys. So they were actually tagging their seals with spray paint. So based on this, we were able to determine where she came from. And this baby seal, who hadn't even molted her coat yet, had already gone for a swim 90 miles and survived it, only to arrive on Ireland's shores and get attacked by dogs, unfortunately. Luckily, we were able to respond. We brought her into our care, and she is thriving. She was released back into the wild about a year ago, and we haven't heard from her since. So that means that we've got every reason to believe that she is thriving in the wild.
Other things people can do to protect marine wildlife include using the Observers app. So we go out on EcoTour operator vessels and we record marine megafauna opportunistically, but we can't be everywhere at once. So that's why we developed the citizen science tool, the Android Observers app, which allows people to submit records of animals that they see. So that includes sharks, skates and rays, cetaceans, whales, dolphins and porpoises, and seabirds. And this year we're going to add in a tuna recording for him as well. So the Observers app also doubles as a free educational tool. Within it, it has ID guides for species that are present in Irish waters, but there's also educational videos that are very short, and they're on topics from biodiversity to ecology. And we recommend that you download it and sign up via the members tab for a free year's membership. And you can submit sightings and strandings of any of the animals that you see, and you'll join our leaderboards and you'll become an ocean hero.
The really important thing to remember is that everything that we do individually makes a difference on the environment around us. We can choose to support sustainable industries. We can shop organic, which is not putting harmful chemicals into the environment. We can reduce our plastic consumption so that less plastic pollution is ending up in the into the waterways. We can also focus more towards a plant-based local diet, so we are doing our part to minimize carbon emissions, and we can also support local sustainable fishing industries so that we're not supporting the harmful industries that are taking too much fish out of the ocean. And another thing that we can all do is to respect wildlife from a distance. If you see wildlife in distress, keep a distance, call a rescue hotline, and just do your part to give wildlife space and respect it, because this is their environment too.
It is every human being's role to save the only planet that we have. It's not just our oceans. Pollution is contaminating our water, land, and even the air that we breathe. For more information on how you can make a change, at the end of my documentary will be a list of organizations that you can join. Or if you're unable to join an organization, then maybe you can make a contribution. Or if you're unable to make a contribution, then maybe you can go on their websites and educate yourself to see if maybe there's something you can change in your daily routine that is affecting our planet. Because if everyone on our planet put our differences aside and came together and made this change, then maybe we can fix the mess that we made. Don't wait for anyone else. The biggest change in the world can all start with you. So join a group like ORC Ireland or the Seal Rescue Centre or other organizations you might come across. Help end the downward spiral that we are on. Be the change that this world needs, because the truth is, it all starts with you.